Hi, my name is Anette, and I will now walk you through the ROEST Web Portal. After receiving your roster, you get access to the web portal. You'll receive a link with your credentials. Type your username and password to log in. On the first screen, you can see your roster. Some customers will have one roster, and some will have multiples. This is how the first screen looks, whether you have one or more machines. On the top menu, Inventory, Cupping, and Profile Library are the same for all the machines you own, while Live, Log, and Profiles are connected to each machine. If you own multiple machines, you can access the menu from the drop-down menu or click on the machine from the main page. On the top right menu, you get access to Support Tickets, the Support Portal with guides and manuals, and the Change Log of the Web Portal with updates from our developers with the changes they have made. When you click on the username, you can access settings. We're going through each part of the menu, and first, let's start with settings. In the global settings, you can set up weights and temperature units. Here you can adjust the maximum chart temperature. For example, during the live roast or in your logs, your chart isn't tall enough to show all the graphs. ROR. Rate of rise interval is used for displaying rate of rise curves. Higher values results in smoother rate of rise curves, and we recommend the default version of 30 seconds. You can add your contact information. We use this email address to send you a new password if that's needed. You can switch between light or dark mode, depending on your preference. Now let's go over to Live View. Before you start, you can choose a previous roasting log as a background for the Live View and select the parameters you want to showcase. Click and close the sidebar. And we are now ready to drop the beans in. Now the roasting process starts, and you can see all the data on the screen. On the bottom, you can see the legend of all the parameters, and you can switch off those that you don't need. On the top left corner, you can add the batch name, the start weight, and what type of bean you are roasting by selecting from Inventory or Free Text. You can choose which data to show on the sidebar by clicking the icon here. There's a lot of parameters to showcase depending on the type of model that you roast on. On the top chart, the temperature sensors and rate of rise is displayed, as well as individual cracks. On the lower chart, you can see the fan, power input, and the RPM of the motor. And below are the roasting stages as drying, yellowing, and development. To remove a log as a background, click Compare with Batch, and then click on the log you had as a background to remove it. Then click and close the sidebar. Once the roasting session is finished and the beans are dropped, the log is automatically saved in Logs. On the right side, here is the button for full screen. To exit full screen, you can press ESC or press the full screen button. You have grouped tooltip, which you can disable, or enable, and download as PDF. You can add comments during the roast. You can edit comments, or you can delete comments. Let's take a look at profiles. The profiles are divided into three sections. The first is assigned profiles, with a maximum of 5 profiles assigned to the machine. The second section is between batch protocol, or BBP, assigned to the machine. Now, this is limited to only one. The third section is all the profiles you have collected or created that are not assigned to your machine. You can create or download as many profiles as you need. The sample roaster can have assigned only 5 roasting profiles and 1 BBP profile, which must be downloaded to the sample roaster. You can then access it when the roaster is not connected to Wi-Fi. When the dot is red in the column, this assigned profile is not downloaded on the machine. You need to download the profile on the machine to access it. When the profile is downloaded, the dot turns green. To assign profiles, click on the arrow in the right column. To create a new profile, click on the plus sign button. There are several roasting profiles or between batch protocols profiles you can make. You will get the various options or parameters for each profile to set up. Let's create an air temperature profile. To create a new profile, you can set a profile name, preheat temp, batch weight, and end condition based on total time, development time in percentage, or bean temperature. To make it helpful for others when you share the profile, it's good to also add metadata. What is the profile for? What type of origin, process, or if you want to add some comments. Now we can start adding points to create your profile. You can manually add points here or double-click to make data points. You can create as many points as you want and then drag them to the desired temperature. You can do the same for fan settings and RPM. Click here to show the predicted rate of rise. If you are using a computer, you might find it helpful to use shortcuts. When the profile is ready, hit the Create Profile button. Your profile is under Profiles in the All Profiles sections. If you want to assign it to the machine, just click here and replace it with whatever profile you want. Let's take a look at power profiles. The target of power profile is how much power you put into the roaster. Now let's create a profile based on the roasting log. What you usually do is roast manually on the power profile. When you're happy with the result, you would like to create a profile out of it. Go to Logs, find the log of the power profile, click on Create a profile from batch, and choose what kind of profile you want to make. For example, let's create an inlet profile out of it, and the editor will take that inlet curve and drop the points based on it. Edit name and details. Now you can adjust it and create a new profile. Another type of profile you can create is between batch protocol. Do it in the same way. Choose which type of profile, for example, air temperature. You can now edit air temp to, for example, 220 degrees. You can adjust the airflow. You will edit the end condition based on total time or drum temp. Once the point is reached, the machine will let you know by an alert. To share profiles, go to the list, choose a profile, and click on the share button. You have two options. Generate a link to share profile privately, or share it into the public profile library. You will now find it in the profile library. If you want to remove it, go back to the profile, click on the button Edit Share Options, and click Remove from Profile Library. Now let's take a look at logs. Here is a list of all the roasting sessions you have conducted. You can sort your logs on different parameters, search batches, compare logs, and decide which columns to show and hide. To access each log, click on the log you want to see. When you enter the log you want to take a closer look at, you'll see how the roasting session went. On the left side, you can see a lot of information about the roast. You can edit batch name and weight at start and at the end, which will calculate the weight loss. You can edit bean color for whole or grounded beans. And you can edit bean type and what type of coffee you are roasting. On the right side of the chart, you can access full screen, toggle profile series, enable or disable grouped tooltip, and download the log as a CSV file or PDF. To zoom in on a specific detail on the graph, you click and mark the area you want to zoom into. And to exit the zoom view, click the Reset Zoom button. Below the chart, you can turn on and off data through the legend. If you don't need all the data, click on it and it will disappear. If you have created comments during the live roast, the comments will be shown here, or you can add comments afterwards. You can delete the batch, create a profile based on this batch, or compare this batch with other batches. Another great feature of the log is that you can compare logs. You can do that from the specific log, or go to the list of all the logs and select the ones that you want to compare. In the column Compare, click on the logs you want to compare. After you have done that, you click Compare. The table on the left shows the data, profile, weight, and etc. You can choose which data to display on the legend at the bottom. If you want to go back, select another log, or remove a log you are comparing, click on List, do the edit you want to do, and go back to compare. You can also compare batches from a specific log. By doing that, you click on Compare with Batch, click on List, and select the logs you want to compare, and then click on Compare. To start a cupping session, you go to Logs, choose the logs you want to cup, go to Cupping, and hit the plus button to create a new one. If you have external samples you want to cup, click on Add External Batch. Give the cupping a name and select the cupping form. You can preview the cupping form by clicking this button. You have the option to run a blind cupping. Now let's start the cupping session. If there's more of you cupping, use this QR code to scan and get access. Then click on Join Session. You fill out the form, add descriptors. The list of descriptors is taken out of the coffee taster's flavor wheel from SEA. And add notes. You fill out for all the samples. And once you are ready, you click the upload button, add your name, and submit. When you have finished your cupping, you will see your results. When the cupping is done, you click on End Session. You will then see all the results. You can download the cupping as a CSV file after it's done. Returning to the logs, you will see the cupping scores next to the cupped log. Profile Library. Here you can see the list of publicly shared Rust roasting profiles. You can search for profiles or use the filter button based on different parameters. You can click on the profile to get a preview and then download the one you like by clicking this button. Make sure to add metadata before sharing it so it's easier for others to filter through the list.